everyone, and welcome to our mission statement of the Eco Farm. We need to raise awareness in our society about the harm caused to the Panchtantras by various human activities. While keeping in mind the importance of being a responsible citizen, we must work together by doing to encourage organic farming in our surroundings. To do the same, we have created this organization and website and are a student-led and student-driven organization that aims at creating awareness about the importance of growing green in our community and to encourage other people to perform organic farming.
So I'll be going over what is organic farming. So first, we decided to research about the advantages and disadvantages of chemical fertilizers, and we came to the conclusion that organic farming was clearly the better choice. Now, it is fairly easy to make an organic farm, but we need to make organic compost or manure. There are two types: vermicompost, which is formed by decomposing constituent materials of the manure using certain species of earthworms, usually the red worms, or green leaf manure, which is a manure made by using regular garden waste, which is mostly composed of green leaves. Both of these manures are excellent sources of important nutrients for the plants. At home, I made a tea leaf manure, which is a natural source of NPK fertilizer. The key features of organic farming are protecting the long-term fertility of soil by maintaining organic matter levels, providing crop nutrients indirectly using relatively insoluble nutrient sources, and nitrogen self-sufficiency.
How to do organic farming? Organic farming system in India is not new and is being followed from the ancient times. We already know the method of farming, which is primarily aimed at cultivating the land and raising crops in such a way that the soil remains fertile. Recycle and reuse. We don't need to invest in fancy pots. We should make use of plastic bottles, buckets, and old bathtubs that aren't in use anymore. Make your own soil. The most important step in kitchen gardening is to make Amrit Mitti, which is a nutrient-rich soil. It also has abundant and diverse microbial life that supports healthy plant growth. Always mulch your soil. Keep it covered with a layer of dry crushed leaves or sugarcane baggers. When the waste becomes too wet, we should add old newspapers, dry leaves, and soils to cover up the same. This helps in reducing loss of water due to evaporation. Always remember to start simple.
First, I'll be going over the story and pictures, how to do organic or hydroponic farming. These are the pictures on our website and on our Instagram page. Then I'm going to talk about organic farming in our society and being a responsible citizen. So Daniel Webster once said that the farmers are the founders of civilization. The importance of being a farmer is in the importance of the food we eat to survive. But all over the world, organic agriculture has been touted as not only a system that can benefit the environment and slow the impact of climate change, but as a more resilient system in the face of an increasingly uncertain future. That is not to say that organic farming is by default better for the environment, but the principles and values of organic farming promote and reinforce the need to create harmonious systems that contribute to and protect the very means by which we derive our food. By being a responsible citizen and responsible consumer, we should volunteer by performing organic farming, respect the rights of others, take responsibility for our actions, and not spread false news. We should raise awareness in our communities by encouraging others to be more sustainable. And of course, we take inspiration from the Sustainable Development Goals, especially SDG.
So I'll be talking about organic farming and how it helps the Panch Tattvas. The Panch Tattvas are the five elements of nature: Prithvi, Jal, Agni, Vayu, and Akash. Organic farming reduces exposure to harmful chemicals. Sites artificially help to make the crops resistant to diseases and hence boost farm output. However, as a side effect, this method eventually leads to contamination of the soil over the long term. Nitrogen is a key ingredient in the manufacture of fertilizers used in traditional farming. As such, its usage has increased exponentially over the last few years. When used on the land, about 2/3 of this nitrogen lands up in rivers and interferes with the marine environment, in turn disturbing the entire ecosystem. Organic farming protects jal and prevents this from happening. Hence, we conclude that organic farming can be sustained for an eco-friendly future and can vastly help the Panchatattvas.
Hello everyone, so now we have the Meet the Team page of our website. I am Anvi Tuteja, the web designer, and we have Karunya Jain and Arya Saraf as part of the social media team. And we have Aditya as our operations and output manager. Here we have our contact details and our Instagram handle, @ecofarm_. Here we have our social page where we have shared the Instagram posts. You can scroll through these posts here, and we encourage you to follow us on our Instagram handle. We hope you enjoyed our presentation, and we hope to bring more soon to you. Thank you so much.